Greetings, cyberdogs and citizens of the internet. This is Rendog coming at you from the maintenance level of the Renstar space platform in this Let's Play Minecraft Feed the Beast series. In the previous episode, we were finishing off the last part of our quad uranium cell factory, and in this episode, my friends, we are going to be taking a break from all of the machines and returning to just some good old crafting and start working on the roof of the power control room, as well as some of the corridors if we have a little bit of time left at the end of the episode. So sit back and relax, my cyber diggity dogs, with your tasty-ass beverage and crunchy-ass freaking snacks. Let's feed the beast that is our mind. Now guys, as you can see, I have been busy down here since you were last with me, and I've pretty much finished off this little part of the maintenance level of the Renstar. And as you guys can see, it is looking absolutely freaking bananas. Damn! Check how sweet it looks around here, man. I just absolutely love this like copper lining of this ventilation shaft things that I've built over here. And these ventilation shafts, they like cover up the shame of all the red alloy wires that run underneath them. And in general, I think it just makes this whole maintenance level look more maintenance levelly, if you know what I'm saying. But I think it looks absolutely pimp McDaddy, man. And I've also run a few of the numbers, guys. And man, I've got some exciting news for you. I've also installed a portal gun pad over here, and I think we're gonna put a portal gun pad in all of the important parts of the Renstar. So wherever we are in the Renstar, we can just portal around. I think that'll be pretty awesome. But guys, I have done a little bit of maths, and I've done it on a piece of paper off camera, so no face palming, please, gentlemen and ladies. I'm pretty sure that I've got my maths right, but please remember, guys, maths is not my strong suit. So if I've buggered this up, then my bad. But what I've been trying to figure out is the following: is the amount of copper made by the centrifuge array going to be enough per cycle of the reactors above to completely restock the reactors with quad uranium cells? That is to say, the reactors above require about 3 hours to run their cycle. So in 3 hours' time, we need enough dense copper plates to create 8 more quad uranium cells. That is what I've been trying to figure out up in here. So here's the freaking lowdown on our quad uranium cell factory, my cyber diggity dogs. An industrial centrifuge requires 8 minutes to produce 4 copper ingots. In the previous episode, we had 5 industrial centrifuges, so every 8 minutes, those industrial centrifuges were producing 20 copper ingots. A nuclear reactor requires about 3 hours to completely consume 4 quad uranium cells. So in 3 hours, 5 industrial centrifuges are able to produce 23 cycles, and that means that they are able to produce 460 copper ingots per nuclear reactor cycle. You still with me, cyber diggity dogs? All right, let's carry on. Now, we know that each reactor requires 4 quad uranium cells. 1 quad uranium cells requires 5 copper dense copper plates to be constructed. So 8 quad uranium cells require 40 dense copper plates to be constructed. Now, in a cycle of our nuclear reactors, we are producing 460 copper ingots, and 1 dense copper plate requires 9 copper ingots. Therefore, per nuclear reactor cycle, we are producing 51 dense copper plates out of 5 industrial centrifuges, and as 8 quad uranium cells only require 40 dense copper plates, we are profiting by 11 dense copper plates every 3 hours, or in other words, every nuclear reactor cycle. So from a copper perspective, 5 industrial centrifuges are enough to fuel 2 nuclear reactors plus 11 dense copper plates as surplus freaking profit. Now, from the tin perspective, we are able to produce 30 tin ingots every 8 minutes. So every 8 minutes, those 5 industrial centrifuges are producing 30 tin ingots, which are being turned into 120 lava cans. And to fully fuel 5 industrial centrifuges with lava cans, we require 80 lava cans per cycle. So once again, every cycle we are producing 120 lava cans, but only require 80 lava cans for that industrial centrifuge cycle. Vis-a-vis, we are profiting 40 lava cans per freaking cycle. That means we are both profiting in copper ingots, or in dense copper plates rather, and in lava cans. And that is freaking epic, man. This factory is 100% sustainable. Now, one of you cyber dogs mentioned adding another industrial centrifuge to make use of that extra lava cannage. And that's exactly what I've done over here. I've installed another industrial centrifuge and I've installed an overflow chest over here. And this overflow chest is catching all of the excess lava cans that are coming out of this little array over here. So that is excellent freaking news, guys. And it also is excellent news because we can now produce enough quadruranium cells to get our nuclear reactors fired up again. So what I want to do now is produce another set of nuclear reactors, another full set of quadruranium cells over here. So I want to get both of the reactors fired up at the same time as all of the centrifuges. And then in 3 hours' time, we'll be able to come and check back. And what we should see is a completely sustainable system. Every single centrifuge should be filled up with lava cans. We should have enough dense copper plates to make another set of quadruranium cells. And that, my friends, will be a happy day because then our copper coming out of the quarries can be put to better use elsewhere. So there we go, guys. Alpha and beta reactors are up and freaking running. That is epic. Oh man, that's awesome. All right, so there's one more thing that I want to do down here, guys, and that is just cover up the shame of some of these red alloy wires. It's just a little bit of shame coverage that I still need to attend to over here. So let's get down to that. But you know what is really hilarious? I kind of knew that we could create a self-sustainable system over here, but I didn't actually plan for it, I guess. I didn't do the maths on it. And it just turned out to actually work very nicely, that five industrial centrifuges can actually sustain two nuclear reactors completely, or should I say, can actually produce enough material to produce 8 quadruranium cells per nuclear reactor cycle. And man, I'm just so happy about that. It's just so awesome. I love Feed the Beast so much, man, especially when stuff like this happens. And you know, I really am enjoying myself right now in Feed the Beast, especially working on like this kind of project, which is a really nice combination of aesthetic crafting and like technical Feed the Beast work, you know. I really love what I've done with these vents over here. I think they look so badass, man. And you know, this quadruranium cell factory, it's in 3 parts. Each part is its own unique function. We've been using a whole bunch of different stuff from Feed the Beast: pneumatic pipes, build pipes, water or liquid pipes, centrifuges, autarkic gates. We're just making such good use of the Feed the Beast mod pack, man, and it's just absolutely pimp McDaddy, man. Oh, I'm so freaking happy right now. But guys, what we need to do now is start working on the roof of the power control room. I want to take a little bit of a break from all of that complicated Feed the Beast crafting and just get down to some good old-fashioned freaking crafting. I want to head into... Hello, Slime. What's up? Say hello to my chainsaw. Bam! I want to head up to the Renstar and start working a little bit on the aesthetics of the roof of the Renstar. And I've just come here to the Metalworks factory, guys, because check it out, man. We have got 34 tin dusts from our new quarries, 18 stacks of iron dust that we need to smelt down, a good few stacks of silver dust. Let's get that jazz smelting down. 13 stacks of copper. That's very, very good news over there. 13 stacks of gold, too, so we'll smelt that down. 15 stacks of aluminum, so wheat, we will get that smelted down too. But man, I just want to start working on the roof of the Renstar, and more importantly, on the roof of the power control room. I mean, basically, the power control room right now is exposed to the freaking elements. You know what I'm saying, people? I mean, it is 100% exposed, and all that water and all that rain is falling on all of that delicate equipment. And we just need to do something about that, man. That needs to be sorted out ASAP. And I'm thinking that, okay, well, we need to get to the cyber labs first, though, because I need to pick up a bit of glass. What I'm thinking is that we make the roof out of iron and we make the roof out of glass. I want to have like a nice clear view of the night sky from inside of the power control room. But I don't know, man. I'm trying to figure out like what kind of build we should make the room. Hello, spider. Take it to your butthole. There we go. Is there another one in here? For some reason, the mob overlay on my map has stopped working. Just kind of annoying. Yeah, there's another spider in here. There we go. So wheat. Threat has been cleared. Oh. I just want to make sure the cyber labs are up and running. Yeah, there we go. Energy is coming in now that our reactors are up and running again. So wheat. All right. Let's get back up to the Renstar over here. And I want to put my pad on the pad over here, man. Bam! There we go. That is so sweet. Check it out. Cyber Labs! Ren, star maintenance level. Man, I'm distracting myself with the awesomeness. I wanted to go to the metalworks factory because we do need to collect a few blocks of iron. We're going to have to cut these down into slabs and whatnot so that we can actually get this done. So let's pick up a few blocks of iron. We might as well just pick up all of them. This metalworks factory is now producing a whole bunch more blocks, which is sweet. And let's get back up to the Renstar, turn off our jetpack hover mode so we can just fly up here at instant speed. There we go. Sweet. All right, check it out, man. This is what I want to do today, guys. I want to work on the roof of the power control room. I want to get this bad boy waterproofed. I wanted to get it looking absolutely pimp McDaddy, man. And what I'm thinking is that I want the surface of the Renstar to kind of resemble like a Star Wars destroyer. You know, on the surface of a Star Wars destroyer, they have all those little structures and towers and stuff like that. It isn't like completely flat, you know. There's like, I don't know, there's a whole bunch of different modules and stuff sticking out of them. And that's kind of what I want to achieve from the Renstar. So when we look at it from like a faraway distance, I want the roof of the Renstar to be all jagged and whatnot. And because every single like module in each, or every single room in each of the modules of the Renstar is different, we can basically achieve that quite easily. So in the power module over here, or the power module of the Renstar, we have like a battery room, which already has a unique look. We've got our power control room over there, which will give a unique look. And we've got our two new nuclear reactor rooms over there, which will give a unique look. So I think that's pretty awesome, man. And then obviously we have the corridors, which will have their own unique look already. So that is pretty awesome. So what I'm thinking is, why don't we start off with like a lining of iron blocks like this? And then, let's have a look. Let's just do like two walls, right? So we don't overdo it. There we go. Let's have a look. Like, yeah, you see, what I really like about this is that there's like this little gap between this tin cover strip and, or yeah, this tin cover over here and the iron block. I kind of like that. It adds like a little indent at the top of the roof. Yeah, that's pretty sweet, man. So then I think, why don't we try this, right? Why don't we cut down these into slabs? And then let's go up one like this. I don't think I want to make the roofs of the Renstar like really pyramidy or really high. I think I want to try and keep them relatively flat, and then try and do like interesting things with their design. You know, we always do like these roofs that are kind of like pyramids. They just go up a level and then up a level and then up a level, and then they all meet up at the top. And I kind of want to experiment with like a different roof design in this series, I think. Just to, you know, try and expand our repertoire of crafting design. You're always trying to get better at this game, man. You can never stop getting better at Minecraft. That's the beautiful thing about it. It's like painting, or it's like art, man. You can just never get better. You can never, like, master Minecraft, which is why I love this game so much. All right, anyway, let's check it out, right? Right, that's looking pretty sweet. Let's look from down here. Yeah, that's really cool. I like how it has this little lip thing over here, this little internal concave thing. Really, really like that, man. That is sweet. I think what we should do, though, I've got an idea, right? You know, this corridor over here is two blocks wide. So why don't we emulate this two block wide corridor with glass? So right above the corridor, we'll have like a corridor of glass. Yeah, that could work pretty freaking sweet, man. So check it out. So the next step will be a layer of glass like this, right? All the way around like this. I also like this gradual increase of height rather than going like a block and then a block and then a block. Because in Minecraft Vanilla, you know, where you don't have the slabs and stuff, or you do have slabs, but you have limited slabs, it's really difficult to make roofs look like they have a nice gradient, because your gradients are always really, really steep, right? Because you're going block up, block up, block up. Where in Feed the Beast, you can actually go like half slab up, half slab up, half slab up. I mean, you can still do that in Minecraft, but it just ain't the same. Because you don't have awesome blocks like these iron blocks over here, man. So let's check it out, right? That's looking pretty awesome, I think. Let's have a look. Yeah, that looks badass, man. All right, awesome. And then, what I think we do then is have another layer of iron. Oh, I've got an idea. We have another layer of iron, and then maybe hovering above the observation platform over here, we have like a light fixture or something like that, right? Yes, that is a freaking sweet idea, man. Let's go pick up. Yeah, we've got 22 inverted lamps in here. Let's pick this up, right? Okay, I tell you what, guys, I'm just going to quickly finish off the entire border over here. I'll bring you back on the other side of this kaplooey, and then we'll look into making that sweet-ass light fixture. Kaplooey! All right, guys, welcome back. I've just finished laying down all of that sweet-ass iron and glass, man, and as you can see, it's starting to look pretty awesome. It's looking a little bit flat, though, so we're going to have to come up with some sweet-ass strategy to sort of fix this flatness over here. But what I do want to do is get these inverted gray lamps installed so we can have a look at what this light fixture idea is going to look like. Let's get these installed and then head down to that observation platform down there and have a look. Man, it is going to be awesome to get this Renstar airtight at last. We got rain falling on nuclear reactors and stuff in here. It just doesn't make freaking sense. All right, let's have a look from down here, man. Yeah, that's looking pretty badass, man. It's still a little bit too flat for my liking, though. Like, literally, this room is now just a box, isn't it? It's like a square freaking box. But I think this little concave over here, or whatever the word is, actually helps to break up that boxiness. But I do think we have to work a little bit harder to do that. Let's have a look at what we're working with over here, guys. So this is kind of flat over here. I think what we should do now, let's add like one more little window of glass in here, right? I kind of want to be able to look up at the night sky from the observation post down below. So let's add like a nice glass window over here. Just keep one open so we can get in there easily. All right, and I think what we want to try and do now, let's have a look at the roof from a distance. I mean, it's looking pretty sweet, but I think it's a little bit too flat right now. So we need to come up with a little strategy to like solve this flatness. And what I'm thinking, right? All right. Check this out, right? Currently, this glass is the only thing that's holding up this metal structure in the middle of the roof, and that does not make freaking physics sense at all. That is a physics fail of epic proportions going on up in there. So why don't we make like some cross beams like this? Okay, yes, this is working. This is freaking working. Let's make cross beams of iron to keep holding this roof up, right? Okay, so this is starting to make more physics sense up in here. Plus, this thing is a space platform, man. You know how much pressure and jazz is going to be on this roof. There needs to be iron crossbars to hold this jazz up. That is for shizzle. All right, let's have a look. All right, so that helps to break up the monotony of the roof. Let's have a look. Yeah, that's badass, man. But that doesn't really help with the flatness of the roof, does it? Yeah. This is a conundrum up in here, man. Oh, whoa. Okay, check it out, right? Why don't we try and put some iron slabs along the crossbars, or perhaps along the entire route of these crossbars, or of this, like, iron slabage that's holding up this light fixture? Check it out. I think I'm onto something here, sub diggity dogs. I am picking up what I'm putting down. Let's just make some more iron slabs up in here. Check it out, right? There we go. You see, now that adds a little bit of depth. I think that could work very nicely. And we could apply the same strategy to the top, right? Oh, yes. It's all coming together. Check it out, guys. Check it out, right? If we look at that from a distance. Oops. Check it out, right? What we basically have here is a reinforced crossbeam of iron. And that reinforced crossbeam of iron has a block of iron in its center with two slabs on either side. So it's 100% symmetrical. So that solves the symmetry problems. And it helps to break up the flatness of the roof. Like, if we just applied this same design to the entire top part of the iron blocks here of the roof, we should, I think, get a pretty freaking sweet-ass effect. All right, check it out, guys. Just laid down the last bit of slabbage over there, and look at that, man. Yeah, that is looking badass. I really like that. That's definitely helped to solve the flattage problem. And what we'll do now is apply the same design to the inside and get a whole layer of slavage added to all of these crossbeams in here. And then we'll have a look at what it looks like from inside. All right, CyberDogs, welcome back. I have just finished applying all of those iron slabs to the crossbeams. And as you can see, it is looking sweet in here, man. There is the moon through the center window also, which is exactly the effect that I wanted to get. And this very small change by adding slabage to these iron crossbars has really helped to break up the flatness of the roof, which is absolutely epic, I think. There's one thing that I don't like in here, and that is this part over here, just below the crossbeams over here. So maybe what we could try and do is use some, let's try and use some of these corner slabs, or these slab corners rather. Let's see if we can actually fix that problem with slab corners. If we just stuck something like that in there. Oh, that's beautiful. That is beautiful, man. That just fixes that problem instantly. Man, I am so very happy with how this power plant room roof has turned out. This is absolutely epic. Right, we're gonna need six more? Oh, we'll just make 16. And this is the tricky part in here, man. And come on. There we go. Well, for the first time since we started this series, the power plant room is now 100% airtight. Ah, just smell that artificial air, man. It is so sweet. Well, actually, it's not airtight yet. Now it is. Bam. Oh, man. That is Pimp McDaddy, man. Let's get a nice good look at this roof. Check it out, guys. Looking absolutely sweet. I'm loving that. Well, mission successful for today's episode, my cyber diggity dogs. Let's head up to the outside of the Renstar, have a look at the roof from above, just to make sure that that is also looking as pimp as possible. Let's have a look, man. Yep, that is looking great, man. I am loving that. Looking excellent. Maybe we could add like an antenna or something like that. Maybe we could add a little something outside here to make it look a bit more interesting. Maybe we could change this layer of iron blocks to some other block, maybe tin blocks or reinforced steel or something like that. That could be pretty awesome, but I'll do a bit of experimenting with that, guys. But I really hope you have enjoyed this episode. It's been a nice little break from some of the crazy ass crafting that we've been doing in the last three episodes, man. We managed to set up a sweet ass factory, but now today we've managed just to build some sweet ass roofage, and I'm going to spend the next half an hour or so figuring out a sweet ass design for the roof of the reactor rooms. In the next episode, guys, we're going to be able to see whether our centrifuge array is going to be able to sustain our quadruranium cell factory, and I will show you a new design for the nuclear reactor room, and we will press on with the construction of the Renstar space platform. We're almost at the end of season one, if you can believe it, and my plan is to finish off the power module of the Renstar before season two. So that is the current goal, guys. Really hope you're enjoying the series so far, and thank you so much for watching. It's been Ren Diggity Dog playing Minecraft Feed the Beast, and we will see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye, my friends.